Now let's see about multiprogramming with variable size partitions. In short, we can call it as MVT, where M stands for multiprogramming, V stands for variable, T stands for tasks. So task is nothing but a partition or a process here. This is an example for contiguous memory allocation. We have two types of contiguous memory allocation approaches. First one, multiprogramming with fixed size partitions. Second one, multiprogramming with variable size partitions. We know what is contiguous allocation. Contiguous allocation means a single contiguous block of memory will be allocated for the corresponding process. So we should not allocate memory in non-contiguous memory locations. Okay, so 1 MB at one set of locations, another MB at another set of location, another MB at another set of locations. Likewise, operating system can't allocate. A single contiguous block of memory will be allocated for the corresponding process. Okay, this approach is mainly useful in order to overcome the drawbacks of multiprogramming with fixed size partitions approach. Okay, let's see what is MVT. Here the name itself specifies the meaning. M means multiprogramming. Multiprogramming means we can place multiple processes in the main memory so that CPU executes all those processes in efficient manner. Next one is V. V stands for multiprogramming with variable size partitions. So variable size partitions. So the number of partitions depends upon the number of processes. Suppose let we have 5 processes, then we should have 5 partitions in the main memory. Suppose if we have 50 processes, then we should have 50 partitions in the main memory. And the size of a partition depends upon the size of a process. Let size of a process is some 50 MB, so the size of the partition will become 50 MB. Let size of a process is 5 MB, then the size of a partition will become 5 MB. So that is about multiprogramming with variable size partitions. So the number of partitions vary. The number of partitions depends upon the number of processes, and the size of a partition depends upon the size of a process. Let's take an example here. Let we have 4 processes, P1, P2, P3, P4, where size of P1 is some 5 MB, size of P2 is 10 MB, size of P3 is some 7 MB, size of P4 is some 20 MB. So these are the 4 processes which are waiting for execution. So here the main memory is divided into 2 parts. The first part contains operating system. Next, this is nothing but the second part is nothing but user part. So this part is subdivided into several partitions, where each partition can accommodate one process. So what is the size of P1? 5 MB. So for P1, the memory will be allocated. So what is the size of P1 here? So 5 MB. So 5 MB of memory will be allocated for P1. Next one is P2 process. Size of P2 is 10 MB. So 10 MB of memory will be allocated for the process P2. Next process is P3, where the size of P3 is 7 MB. So 7 MB memory is allocated for P3. Next process P4. So for P4, 20 MB of the memory will be allocated. Okay. So this is nothing but multiprogramming with variable size partition. So here the first partition size 5 MB, second partition size 10 MB, next partition size 7 MB, next partition size 20 MB. So the size of a partition depends upon the size of a process. Next, number of partitions depends upon the number of processes. Okay, let's see the advantages of this approach, multiprogramming with variable size partitions. The first advantage of this approach is there is no internal fragmentation. There is no internal fragmentation. Why? Because we know what is internal fragmentation. Internal fragmentation will occurs in multiprogramming with fixed size partitions. So in the technique, what will happen? The size of a partition is fixed. let our size of a partition is 5 MB, whereas let the size of a process is 3 MB. So if we store 3 MB of the process in 5 MB of this partition, then what will happen? 2 MB will be wasted. This wastage of space is known as internal fragmentation. Whereas in multiprogramming with variable size partition, there is no internal fragmentation. Okay, why? Because here we are allocating the memory depends upon its request. So no internal fragmentation will arise in the partition. Okay, so this is the first advantage. And the second advantage is there is no limitation on the number of partitions. There is no limitation on the number of partitions. Suppose if there are 10 processes, then main memory can store those 10. By making 10 partitions. Suppose if there are 100 partitions, then main memory creates 100 partitions for storing those 100 processes. So that is the second advantage here. There is no limitation on the number of partitions or the number of processes. Okay, the number of processes. And the third advantage is there is no limitation on the size of a process. No limitation on size of a process. So let size of a process is 20 MB, then 20 MB of the memory will be allocated for P4. Let size of a process is some 200 MB. So if main memory free space permits, then 200 MB of the memory will be allocated for process P4. Okay, so that is the third advantage. No limitation on the size of a process. Okay, so these are the advantages of the multiprogramming with variable size partitions. Now let's see the drawbacks of this approach. The first drawback is it is difficult to implement this approach. Why? Because we have to allocate the memory dynamically, depends upon the size of a process. So for implementing, we need to write in operating system, we have to write many lines of code. So we can say that it is difficult to implement this approach. And the second problem is external fragmentation. So let's see what is external fragmentation here. And let us assume that process P1 has completed all its operations. Process 3 is also completed all its operations. Let here the main memory is completely full. So main memory has only 4 partitions. Let us assume that. Okay, so let we have one more process whose size is 10 MB. Then is it possible to store this process, P5 process, in the main memory? It is not possible. Why? Because this is an example for contiguous allocation. So a single block of memory, a single contiguous block of memory needs to be allocated for the process. But a single 10 MB of the block is not available in the main memory. Okay, so this is the problem here. This problem is known as external fragmentation. External fragmentation means even though there is a sufficient space available in the main memory, but operating system can't allocate this memory for storing the corresponding process. Why? Because here the memory locations are non-contiguous. So 5 MB is stored at one block, 7 MB is stored at another block. So these locations are non-contiguous. Okay, so this is the problem here. These two are the drawbacks of the multiprogramming with variable size partitions. Here we can solve external fragmentation problem with the help of a technique called compaction. So compaction means combining the free partitions, adding the free partitions and producing a new block. Here we can convert this main memory into like this. So the first part contains operating system. So first we have to move the allocated processes towards up. So what is the first allocated process? P2. So P2 will be shifted towards up. The size of the P2 is 10 MB. Next allocated process is P4. So P4 will be shifted towards up. The size of P4 is 20 MB. Next, what are the free blocks? This is one free block whose size is 5 MB. This is another free block whose size is 7 MB. So these two blocks are combined and make them as a new block. So 5 plus 7 means 12 MB. So this is nothing but new partition or block or fragment or hole, everything is same only. Okay, so now what is the size of this partition? 12 MB. So in the 12 MB we can store P5 here. So this is nothing but compaction. So what is a compaction? So compaction means we are using compaction mainly to overcome the problem of external fragmentation. Okay, so compaction means combining the free partitions and making them as a new block. So in that block we can store the new process. So these are the various advantages and disadvantages of multiprogramming with variable size partitions.